Hi everyone, Fox is here and I'm bringing you my June book haul. This is undoubtedly the most curious book haul ever. First of all, I'm in a different location. I'm on my couch for a reason. Right now, if you don't know, if you don't follow soccer, there is a Euro Cup which is going on in France. And right this second when I'm filming, France is playing Iceland. And it's the end of the first halftime and I'm sitting there facing my TV because I'm trying to watch soccer while I'm filming, which is absolutely crazy. And unfortunately, Iceland is losing, but yeah, I'm cheering for Iceland, yes. Also, please excuse my very flushed face, but I was just outside because today is the Pride Parade day. And I went there just to have a very quick look around, and it's, as usual, very crowded, very hot. That's why I'm really flushed. And if you hear any noise, that's music outside because I live essentially on the route of Pride Parade in Toronto. And it's really, really noisy and loud outside. I close my window, but there is nothing else I can do here. If you hear anything, just please ignore it. A lot of booktubers start their book haul video saying they don't know how they manage to accumulate so many books. I, in my turn, actually do know how I accumulated so many books. That's because I was stress buying. Whenever I'm stressed and I've had a very busy month at work, I just tend to go online and buy books, especially when I see a sort of a deal. And Book Outlet had a sale, Indigo had some sort of promo, and Amazon as well had a sale for YA books. So yeah, I just went online and I bought a lot of books, and they all started coming out, like coming to me at the same time. Which resulted in me just basically piling boxes upon boxes upon boxes. It was insane. I'm not going to go into much detail about the books. I'm not going to say anything. You probably know a lot of these books just because I decided to buy a lot of books that were really hyped or really talked about online right now. And without further ado, let's just get started. Okay, so the first books that I have here are Royal Assassin and Assassin's Quest by Robin Hobb. As you can see, quite big chunky books, high fantasy. These are books number 2 and 3 from the Farseer trilogy that I'm reading right now for the Hobbelon read-along organized by Samantha. And I got this from Book Depository as well as book number 1, but they're really different in size compared to book number 1. I'm a bit sad about this, but at the same time, the font is way easier on the eyes, and I'm really excited and cannot really wait to read them. Another book that I got from Book Depository is Uprooted by Naomi Novik, and this is a paperback and a UK edition, and I really like this cover. I decided to pick this book up because when I borrowed the book from the library, I didn't have time to read it and I had to return it. And as it stands right now, there are so many people requesting this book that I didn't want to wait, so I just went ahead and purchased it. It's a YA fantasy novel. Some time ago, I decided to finally acquire books from the Mortal Instruments series by Cassandra Clare because I haven't read them yet. And I do have book number 1 in the series that I purchased from Book Outlet some time ago, and that's a new paperback 2015 edition. And one day, I went to Book Depository and saw that they were selling books 2, 3, and 4 for like $7 or something plus free shipment, and I just went immediately and purchased them. Those books took a while to get here, so I ordered them back in May and only received them in June. That's why I'm holding them now, but I was really disappointed when I got them since these books were from completely different editions. As you can see, these are completely different editions. This one does look a bit like US edition, but these ones are very old editions. Even though the preview images on the website were completely different, this is what I've got. And this book is actually, it's a UK edition or I don't know what, yeah, it's a UK edition, and even though it looks like US edition, it's quite smaller in the size. And when I approached Book Depository about it, they told me that I should have paid attention to ISBN numbers instead of actually looking at the covers. That really disappointed me. I did not expect them to say that. I know that I didn't look at the ISBN numbers myself, and this is what I usually do when I purchase books, but at the same time, I'm so used to Amazon, who is pretty accurate with book covers. When I got this, I got really disappointed because my book number one did not match these. So I went to Book Outlet and purchased correct copies of this. From Book Outlet, I purchased books 2, 3, 4, and 6, so I'm missing book number 5. And I also purchased the Infernal Devices books 1, 2, and 3. I got them really cheap and I'm really excited. I still don't know what to do with those books that I purchased from Book Depository, but as you can tell, there is a huge difference. This is US edition, this is UK edition. They're different in size, very different. And even though covers look the same, they're not the same. So yeah, I'm really disappointed in Book Depository, and I even decided not to purchase anything from them anytime soon. I did purchase a couple of books from them, but so far I'm sticking to Amazon and Book Outlet. I'm not sure when I'm going to get to the Mortal Instruments series, but I'm really excited to have the books. I still need to purchase book number 5, but I'm pretty sure I'll get it from Book Outlet as well. Another book that I got from Book Outlet is Fireified by Brandon Sanderson, which is book number 2 in the Reckoner series. I have book number 1. I haven't read it yet, but decided to purchase book number 2. Another book that I've got from Book Outlet is Zeros by Scott Westerfeld. I don't know why, but I've been eyeing this book for a while. It's a YA dystopian fantasy something, but I heard good things about it. Really wanted to read it for some time. Hopefully, it will not disappoint. Another book that I've got from Book Outlet is White Cat by Holly Black. Ever since I read The Darkest Part of the Forest by Holly Black, which I really, 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 really enjoyed, and that was probably one of my favorite books of 2015, I decided to read more books by her, and since this one was on sale at Book Outlet, I got it. Another book that I've got from Book Outlet is actually not a book but a coloring book, and that's Cats in Paris. I got this book just because of the title, and actually, the pictures are pretty cute, but it's not for me, it's for my friend who, thank goodness, doesn't know I have a YouTube channel, so it's going to be a surprise for her. Okay, moving on very quickly. I made a lot of random purchases this month, and among them, these two books which I saw on Cece's channel. She was doing LGBTQ+ readathon, and she read these two books. One is Every Heart a Doorway by Seanan McGuire, and this one is The Abyss Surrounds Us by Emily Skrutkovsky. Yeah. She really enjoyed these two books, and I decided to purchase them as well. I have actually already read Every Heart a Doorway, and I absolutely loved it. It's a YA fantasy book, and it's really, really whimsical. Really enjoyed it. I'm going to link my weekly wrap up below just for you to hear more thoughts about it. Really enjoyed this one. Haven't read this one, but looking forward to it. I recently met a friend who was highly recommending that I start reading The Raven Boys Cycle by Maggie Stiefvater, and I did read one book by Maggie Stiefvater about 2 years ago, and that was The Scorpio Races, which I absolutely loved. I was trying to read her other series. I think it was called Shiver. So I started reading book number 1, which was Shiver, but I never got to other books, but I'm really interested in reading the Raven Cycle, so I just went ahead and purchased all of them. Yes, in hardbacks because of the reasons. I also shopped at Indigo both in the store and online. It was so crazy because at some point I was just going to Indigo almost every single day just to browse because I needed to, relax and calm down and wind down from the day, and I sometimes ended up buying books. Here we go. The first book that I want to show you that I purchased from Indigo is A Monster Calls by Patrick Ness. I love this book. I read it last summer, borrowed it from the library, and absolutely adored it. It's A very nice edition. I wished I had a hardback, but I still like this one. It has gorgeous illustrations that really add to the story. I don't want to call it a graphic novel because it's not. It's a novel, but it has absolutely gorgeous illustrations. I read it last year, loved it, and finally I have my own copy. Another book is also by Patrick Ness, and that's More Than This. This is a YA fantasy slash dystopia slash sci-fi. Ooh, I don't even know what to call it, but it's a very curious book, and it's very, very well written. Read it last summer, loved it, and now I finally have my own copy. I was waiting to get hardback just because of this. Just because of this. Because I wanted this. Yes. And I finally have it. Another book that I purchased and which I have already read is Rook by Shannon Cameron. I read it last year, borrowed it from the library, really enjoyed it. It's a very nice fantasy-esque dystopian YA novel with a lot of adventures and sword fight and, you know, intrigue and all of that, and I really enjoyed it. And at some point during this year, I realized that I kept thinking about it and I wanted to read it again, just because when I read Truth Witch by Susan Denard, I felt that there were some similarities between these two books, so I decided to purchase it, and here you go. Let me just say that I love this edition, even though the paperback just recently was released and it also has the same style to it, the same, you know, decorations around chapters. I still wanted a hardback, so I got it. Then I got myself The Assassin's Blade by Sarah J. Maas, which is a collection of novellas, a prequel to the Throne of Glass series, and I decided to start with this one, even though I probably should be starting with book number one. Actually, I'm not sure if you know whether I should be starting with this one or book number one, because I also own book number one. Just let me know down below. I was actually thinking about starting with this one. Probably it makes more sense, but let me know. Then I got myself Fallen Kingdoms by Morgan Rhodes, because everyone is talking about these books and I need more fantasy in my life. Then I got The Scorpion Rules by Erin Bow, and I've been meaning to read this book for a while, and when I saw that it was released quite recently in this absolutely gorgeous paperback, I was just like, yeah, I need it because it's gorgeous, I love this cover. So yeah, here I go. Then I got Julia Vanishes by Catherine Egan, and I heard a lot of people mention this book, supposedly it's a good one, so yeah, I'm going to read it, hopefully it does not disappoint. Another book that I picked up was a complete spontaneous purchase, and that's The Sin Eater's Daughter by Melinda Salisbury. Know nothing about this book, I just saw that book number 2 was recently released, and I really liked the cover, so I went to search for book number 1. The cover and the premise seemed really intriguing. It's a YA fantasy. So I decided to pick it up, and since nobody's talking about it, might be a good thing. Okay, now we're getting to adult fantasy. I bought so much fantasy this month. It's ridiculous, but this is what I want to read right now. So probably it makes sense. I got this book only because Samantha was talking about it, and even though she had a bit of mixed feelings about it, I heard some of the buzzwords in her review that made me really, really interested in this book, and that's The Fifth Season by N.K. Jemisin. And I don't really know much about this book except for there is a fifth season and it's a fantasy, adult fantasy. So yeah, here we go. Other two books that I've got are Red Seas Under Red Skies and The Republic of Thieves by Scott Lynch. These are books number 2 and 3 in his Lies of Locke Lamora series. I read book number 1 a while back. I have it in paperback, in mass paperback. And also I purchased book number 1 in a different edition which matches this one. And then I realized that my book number 2 was in a different edition, so I just went ahead and purchased books number 2 and 3 because apparently book number 4 is coming out this summer. So yeah, I need to read this because it's been a while since I read book number 1, and I don't really think that I read book number 2. Actually, I don't remember. So yeah, I decided to purchase these editions. The following 4 books that I have on hand are all books number 1 in high fantasy series, and some of them were on my wish list for quite a while before I purchased them, and that's book number 1, The Way of Shadows by B. Brent Weeks. I know that Samantha read it and enjoyed it, and I also had it for God knows how long on my wish list, so I decided just to go ahead and purchase it. Then I have Prince of Thorns by Mark Lawrence. This is also another book which was read by Samantha, and I have already figured out that we have quite similar tastes, so I'm looking forward to reading this one. Then I got Beyond the Pale by Mark Anthony, which is book number one in the Last Rune series, and I read this book ages ago, like 15 or 20 years ago, and I remember enjoying it, but I never finished the series, and I don't even know where my copies are now, so I just went ahead and purchased this one. It's a very old fantasy series back from the whatever 90s or 80s. I'm looking forward to reading this. I don't know, I barely remember the plot, so I don't know whether I will enjoy it or not, but I guess we'll just have to wait and see. Then I got The Ring of Lightning by Jane Asfencher. I've had this book on my wish list for God knows how long as well, and it actually went out of print in a while back, and I was trying to find this book on book outlet or somewhere in the indie bookstores, but it was always like in very bad condition, so I went ahead on Amazon and purchased it from one of the sellers on Amazon Marketplace, and you know what, it's in perfect condition. I paid 1 cent for this book. I purchased it and it was delivered from US, so I had to pay for the delivery, but the book itself was 1 cent. Jesus, it's almost new. Like, honestly, it's almost in mint condition. There is, as you can see, some of the pages are bent here, but it's because it was packed really badly and the package got squeezed a bit. But otherwise, I don't know much about it, except for it's a high fantasy world and apparently there is some queer characters in it. So yeah, I'm looking forward to reading this one. Okay, and the last book that I have to show you is the book that I got on Thursday, which is almost a week before the release date, and I'm really confused, and that's The Savage Son by V. Schwab. I pre-ordered this book at Indigo and got it shipped to the store, and I thought it was coming out on 4th or 5th of July, but I actually picked it up on Thursday, and I'm so surprised by it. So yeah, here we go. This is a fantasy YA series, I believe, book number one. I really, really enjoyed V. Schwab's writing. I read only Vicious so far, but it was amazing. One of my favorite reads so far this year. So yeah, I'm looking forward to reading this one. Okay, here we go, guys. This is it. This is my June book haul. I solemnly swear that I'm not going to purchase any books anytime soon unless I have already pre-ordered something or if there is a book in the series that I need to purchase. But otherwise, I'm on a book buying ban. It's not a joke. I spent too much money on these books, and even though it did make me feel emotionally way better when I purchased them, I still know that I basically am running out of money and running out of space on my shelves. This is not even funny. I purchased 41 books this month, and that's not counting what I purchased on my Kindle. This is way too much. This is way too much, and this has to stop. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video. I probably will not be making any book haul videos anytime soon unless I get sent something or, I don't know, something else happens. So yeah, but please let me know down below if you read any of the books that I mentioned or if you purchased any of the books that I mentioned recently. I would love to know what you think about them. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you very soon. Bye! And France just scored. It's 3-0. Iceland was amazing. Iceland is the smallest nation to participate in the Euro Cup. The population of the country is less than the population of Ottawa. It's 320 or 330,000 people. It's insane. They did so amazing in this championship. It's unbelievable. I don't know how the small nation managed to produce the team that got to quarterfinals. It's unbelievable, and kudos to them. They really, really tried their hard, and they deserve to be in quarterfinals. I'm just sad that they had to face a very strong team, which is France, and I'm even happy that I'm filming right now and I'm not able to watch the game, because after watching Germany play Italy last night, and I'm supporting Germany. I was so stressed and so anxious. I couldn't really calm down, even though Germany won. It was still so freaking stressful because they went to penalties, and that like those were the longest penalties shootout, like, in the whole history of the championship. That's unbelievable. Okay, enough with soccer, back to books. The only way that I can really, you know, what? Did they just score again? Oh, for goodness sake, it's 4-0, just stop it. Oh my god, I cannot watch. You know what I realized when I was editing my last video is that I tend to say book depository instead of book depository, and I have no explanation for it because I know how to pronounce depository. I just end up always saying book depository. I don't know why. If anyone can explain it to me, please do, because I don't get it. It's so difficult to film in a new location just because I'm so used to, you know, holding books with my left hand, and it's not exactly working right now just because I'm trying to face window so that there is more light. So France is still playing Iceland, and it's the 62nd minute of the game, and it's 5-1. France obviously leading. Feels so bad for Iceland. My poor babies. They tried, they really tried.